everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you're joining me for this warm-up. My name is Kendall. Like I said, I'm going to be leading you through a warm-up for today. So whenever you're ready, you can grab a mat, grab your water bottle, and we will just get right into it. So first of all, we're going to start out with just some step touches. Get our bodies moving, feeling great for today. All right, next for the next 30 seconds, we're going to add in some bicep curls. Great job. If you want, if you have some weights at home, you can definitely add those in at this point. Also, feel free to use no weights as well. Great job. You can also modify this a bit with your pace. But just do what's feeling comfortable for you as we're getting warmed up. Great job. 3, 2, 1. Now we're switching to overhead press. Keeping that step touch again and just overhead press. Again, you can modify this stepping with your overhead press as we're getting those shoulders and upper arms worked. Great job. Again, feel free stepping at whatever pace feels comfortable for you. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, and 1. All right, shake it out a bit. We're going to move into some marching. Great job. Feel free to drive those knees up. Great job. All right, next we're going to add in a cross-body elbow touch. So we're going to touch our knees to our elbows. 3, 2, and 1. Great job. This is for 30 seconds. Wonderful. Keep breathing through this. This is really working those abdominal muscles, especially our obliques. Great job. 3, 2, 1, 0. Nice job. Another little shake out. Next thing we're going to do is a walking calf raise. So we'll just 1 foot in front of the other and then up on both feet for a calf raise. Great job. This is for 30 seconds as well. Just alternating feet in whatever space you're walking in. For a bit of a higher intensity, you can hold for longer at the top and come back down. Also focusing on balance as we're doing this. Great job. Of course, breathing through all of these as our heart rate is starting to come up. Job. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Great job. All right, next thing that we are going to move into is a squat with a side kick. So we're going to spread our legs a little bit past shoulder width. We're going to squat down to about 45 degrees, back up, kick out with our right leg. We're going to go back down to our left leg. We're going to do 5 on each side. So we've got 1 down so far. Kick out. Squat down 45 degrees. Up and kick out. Great job. 3 more each side. Definitely position your feet where it feels comfortable for you. Like I said, a bit wider than shoulder length. Great job. Perfect. Keep breathing through this. 1 more each side. Kick. And last one. Up. Kick. Great job. Next thing, we're going to move into a little bit of a stretch with a side lunge hold. So you can just, again, a little more than shoulder width apart. We're going to lean into our left side, keeping our right leg straight. Just lean into this stretch for about 30 seconds. Again, focusing on our breathing, making sure we're not holding our breath, adjusting position, making sure our toes are pointed forward, keeping our right leg straight as we feel that stretch through our legs. Great job. 3, 2, 1. Switch into the other side. Same thing. Adjust positioning as needed. Keep our left leg straight now. We're leaning into our right leg. Feeling that stretch out our inner legs up here, inner upper legs. Great job. Good job holding this. At any time, if you need a quick pause for a water break, feel free to do that as well. Stay hydrated. 3, 2, 1. All right, next thing we're gonna do is move into some lunges. So we'll start with our right foot planted forward, our left foot in the back, and we're just gonna go down for a lunge and come back up. And we're gonna hold this position. We're gonna do 7 on each side. So down, up. We want our right leg to go about 90 degrees. We don't want our knee to go over our toe. So feel free to adjust your positioning as needed to make sure that happens. We want our left leg to come down, but not quite touch the ground. Also focus on our balance here as well. Last one for our right leg. Up, great job. Switch, left leg forward, same thing. Down and up, great job. Wonderful. If you want higher intensity, you can also pulse for a second down here and then back up. Job. Continue to breathe through these. Great job. Remember, no knees over toes. Last one. Great job. All right. Next thing, we're going to move into a bit of a stretch. It's what I like to call standing Superman. So we'll raise our right arm and just like Superman pose and lean a bit to our left. You want to add higher intensity for this and some balance work, you can also raise that right leg. Also feel free to keep both feet planted as we focus on that stretch for our abdominals. Good job. Feel free to lean until you feel that point of stretch. About 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. We're going to switch to the other side, roll it out a bit, left arm up, and stretch. Again, holding for 30 seconds. Feel free again to lift up that left leg for some balance work for a higher intensity, or keep both feet planted. Again, breathing through all these, never holding our breath, always stretching. It's just the point of tension, but never any discomfort. So wherever that falls for you. Great job. 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Another little shake out. Next, we're going to come to a wall. So just any wall that you have near you. And you're going to stick your hand straight out like this and place it against the wall, and so you'll stand for a second with their straight. Once you have that position where it feels comfortable, about right out from your shoulders, then turn yourself so your body is perpendicular to your hand, and you should begin to feel a stretch throughout your biceps and shoulders. We're holding this for about 30 seconds. Again, just breathing through it. Very good job. Feeling this, Feel free to turn your body more if you don't quite feel that stretch. Again, just always to a point of discomfort, never pain as we're going through this. Great job. 3, 2, 1. Now we're going to do that same thing on our opposite arm. So just straight out from us. Get that position settled. Then rotate our body outwards so we feel that stretch here through our chest and in our bicep muscles as well. Again, holding this, starting to feel nice and warm during this warm-up. Again, never holding our breath as we're doing this, enjoying the stretch, thinking about our workout we're going to do after this. Great job. 3, 2, and 1. All right, next we are going to move down onto the ground. So if you have a mat, that'll be great for this. And we're going to get on our knees planted and then our hands as well, just directly below our shoulders. And we're going to do opposite hand and leg reaches. So that'll mean out with our right arm and directly back with our left leg. And we're doing 7 on each side. So out, then back in, out, back in. Great job. Nice and slow and controlled here. Breathing through. Always at a pace that feels comfortable for you, where you can also maintain your balance. Great job. Perfect. Almost there. 2 more each side. Great job. Last one. Beautiful. Now we're going to stay in this same position. And we're going to do straight leg fire hydrants. So you guys might have done fire hydrants before, but this time our legs are remaining straight and we're just lifting up. 7 on each side. Good job. 2 more. Last one. Great job. Now let's switch to that right leg. Again, 7 on that side, straight leg out, raise, and back down. Keep that toe pointed. Great job. Perfect. 2 more. Last one. Awesome, great job. Now we're also gonna just stay in this position while we're here and do the cat-cow stretch. So again, just our arms directly below our shoulders. We're gonna start by rolling our back up, tucking our chin into our chest. Hold for about 2 seconds. And we're gonna roll face forward, have that dip in our back, hold. Back up. We're doing 5 of these total, so that was just 1. Hold and roll back. That dip in our back, face forward. Great job. Again, really focusing on your breathing. Roll forward. Just really getting that good stretch. Right, back up, transitioning from this position, we're just going to go ahead and lower our pelvis down onto the ground into the seal stretch, which will stretch out our abdominals. We're going to hold this for 30 seconds as well. Again, just breathing through. Feel free to move your arm position. Again, we want to feel that stretch to a point of tension, but never any pain. The closer that you're able to move your arms towards your body, you'll be able to feel that stretch through your lower abdominals as well. Looking just straight forward, breathing, feeling that stretch. Great job. Wonderful. Three, two, one. Nice job. All right, next we're just gonna slowly transition towards our laying down on our backs. And we are going to do single legged glute bridge holds. So we'll start with keeping our right foot planted. And we're just going to lift up and lift our left leg with us to a glute bridge. Squeeze our glutes at the top and back down. We're doing 5 of these on each side, or with each leg raised. Great job. Make sure you squeeze those glutes at the top and back down. 2 more. Up, down. Great job. Up, down. Nice job. Now we're going to plant our left foot. Keep our right foot extended and do the same thing. Raise up, down. Great job. 5 again. So we've got 3 more. Down, nice. Great job, last one. Perfect. Now while we're in this position, we're gonna move to bicycles for 30 seconds. So if you just wanna start, got that bicycle motion. If you need a modification, you can always just hold your legs about 6 to 8 inches off the ground. The lower you hold them, you'll feel higher intensity. But if you can, do these bicycle kicks, yes. Great job. Feeling those abdominal muscles work. In 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Now we're just going to slowly move into a seated position. Don't go too fast as we're transitioning here. So just however much time you need. We're gonna keep our left leg extended, cross our right leg over, and we're gonna put our left elbow on our right leg and push away and turn our body outwards for this stretch. This will hit a bit of our glutes as well as our erector spinae in our back. Great job. Again, focusing on breathing as we're carrying out these last couple stretches. 5 more seconds here. 3, 2, 1. We're just gonna switch to our other side. So right leg out, left leg crossed over, our right elbow to left knee, and just turn out our body again. Great job. We're almost done here. Just wrapping up. Perfect. Again, always just breathing through these stretches. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. Next thing while we're in this position is stretching out our hamstrings. So we'll kind of make what looks like the number 4 with our leg crossed in and just reach towards our toes on our hamstrings just as far as you can. If you can't fully grab that toe, not a worry. I definitely can't. Again, again, always just to the point of tension, never anything painful. You stretch there. In about 5 seconds, we're going to point that toe back. So either directly pull on that toe if you're grabbing onto it, or point that toe back towards your body, and you'll feel the stretch shift into your calves. So let's switch to that now. Point back. Again, as soon as you start to feel that tension, that's a great place to stop. You never want any pain as we get those calf muscles stretched out. 3, 2, 1. Same thing on our other side. We'll start with our hamstrings and then move into that calf stretch. Great job. In 3, 2, 1. So again, pull those toes back or just directly point them back towards your body. And hold that. Stretch our calves. Wonderful job, everybody. Thanks for sticking with me this whole time. In 3, 2, 1. Nice job. All right, next we're going to move to kneeling position. Again, just slowly as we transition here before we stand back up, we're going to put our right foot forward, our left foot back, so we create a pretty decent amount of space in between our heel and our knee. And we're just going to sink forward, push forward, and with that right leg. We don't want our knees to go over our toes. This is stretching out those hip flexors. We're just going to hold this, get that nice stretch. Wonderful job. Perfect. 3, 2, and 1. And we're just going to switch legs. So we'll plant our right knee down, left foot forward. Again, making sure we have enough space between our heel and our knee, that when we push forward, our knee doesn't go over our toes and we really feel that stretch through our hips. Great job. Like I said, we're almost done. We're wrapping up. Just getting those good stretches in before you'll move on to your next workout. So I appreciate y'all being with me today and I hope it's been enjoyable. Perfect. 3, 2, 1. Nice job. All right, now we're just going to slowly stand back up to be on both of our feet. A nice little shake out, and we're going to do a quadriceps stretch. If you need to, feel free to use something for support, a chair, a wall, anything like that. And you'll just grab one leg at a time. We'll stretch out those quads. Like I said, feel free. Grab a chair, grab onto a wall if needed. If you squeeze your glutes throughout this stretch, you'll really be sure to feel it in your quads. Nice job. 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Now we'll lift up our other leg. Work. And just breathe in. I know our heart rate's getting up, making sure we're getting enough oxygen in there. Wonderful job. 3, 2, 1. All right. Next thing we're going to move into is just some leg circles. And while we're doing that, we're going to stretch our arms as well, just reaching across our body, stretching those arms out. Beautiful job. Feel free to touch down if you need it to regain your balance. Do some big circles, slow and controlled, some small circles. Again, like I said, feel free to touch down. job. 3, 2, 1. All right, switch to our other side. Reach our arm across. And some leg circles. Nice job. Almost done. We've got one last thing to end on a cardio note. Then you guys will be done. Sorry. Always feel free to touch down to regain that balance. I know I need to, for sure. 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Now, like I said, we're going to end on a cardio note with some ski jumpers. So if you've never done these before, how it'll look is you'll step your right leg behind your left leg, right leg back, left leg behind. We're going to do this for 30 seconds. If you want higher intensity, you can add a jump in like this, or you can always just keep it with a step. But we're ending on this cardio note. All I need is 30 seconds from you, and you'll be off to your next workout. Great job. Finish strong. Nice. Halfway there. Nice job, everybody. Keep it up, keep it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great job.